I'm Rob Stavinga, and I'm here with Bird of the Week. And this week, we are not going to talk about a specific bird. We're going to talk about bird migration. So migration is when a species of animal or bird moves from one geographical area to another geographical area. So migration in birds is stimulated by what's happening with the length of the day and our temperatures. And those changes also stimulate some changes in the birds themselves. They go through a hormonal change where they're actually starting to feed a little bit more and put on weight for their migration. And they become a lot more, active, and they start to group together and mass together in larger groups when they're flocking birds like blackbirds and red-winged blackbirds. So different species of birds migrate at different times of the day. So soaring birds like hawks and other types of raptors, they take advantage of warm air currents, so they migrate during the daytime. And a lot of the songbirds migrate at night because they're taking advantage of the calm conditions and the cool nighttime temperatures. And it's also a time when they're avoiding those predators that are migrating during the day. So in Ontario, there's approximately 145 to 150 species of birds that are migratory species. And the great thing about migration is they pass through all kinds of different areas on their way south. So we could potentially see all of those species pass through the city of Kawartha Lakes. So for the average person who's interested in birds, this is a great time to clean out your bird feeders and make sure that they're nice and clean so you're not passing on any diseases, and to make sure that your bird feeders are full, because birds, not only at the time that they start their migration, but during their migration, will stop over in various areas looking to feed and to regain some of the energy they've lost during migration. That's also one of the reasons that areas like Ken Reed Conservation Area and the other conservation areas that we have in our jurisdiction are so important, because birds rely on the habitats that we have in our conservation areas to stop over, to rest, to feed, to take cover from predators. And you can also promote that type of habitat in your own backyard. So by providing native plants and different types of habitat in your yard, you also provide a place for migratory birds to rest and to feed. Well, the city of Kawartha Lakes, in some of my past segments I've mentioned, is a great place for birding because there's a number of areas where you can see migratory birds. Again, conservation areas and things like that, places where you have a large concentration of natural habitat, are great places to see birds. Around me, we're in a cattail marsh, and a lot of times at this time of year you see red-winged blackbirds and grackles and things like that massing together in large flocks, and they're getting ready for their migration. So the time of day for different species, so if you're looking for to see some of the soaring birds, then during the day you can usually see hawks and things like that that might be moving through the area. I find early evening is a really good time to start seeing some of the flocking birds when they're sort of massing together, and they almost do like pre-flight before they take off to start flying south. In the evening, they tend to get more active, and they tend to be more agitated by the migratory conditions. So if you want to see large flocks of birds, that's a great time to come out.